Hi, my name is Anne McCarthy, and I'm a member of Our Lady of the Rosary Cathedral in San Bernardino. Thank you for joining us on iGod today. In today's first reading, Revelations chapter 3, verses 1 through 6 and 14 through 22, there is more than a simple dichotomy taking place here. On one hand, we see clearly that those who are for God are the victors, and those who are not, they're asking for trouble. The angel says, "I know your works. I know that you are neither cold nor hot, because you are lukewarm. I will spit you out of my mouth." Good grief, God pulls no punches. Just when you thought the baptismal water was safe. Yet, St. John is persistent. Whoever has ears ought to hear what the Spirit says to the churches. His message? Hear and repent. In the Gospel, Zacchaeus is the chief tax collector. He was a very wealthy man, but very short in stature. So he ran ahead, climbed a sycamore tree to catch Jesus' attention. Christ, knowing the man's heart, calls him down and asks to stay with him even before Zacchaeus repents out loud. Now here's the part of today's scripture that fills my soul with so much hope. It's almost funny how the passage doesn't mention this. Zacchaeus is actually at the end of a journey that began somewhere. We're not given any information regarding Zacchaeus' beginning to his journey, or the middle, just the end. Somewhere, he heard Christ's message, and it's reached his heart and soul. And he listened. Is it possible that God is making it clear that we must listen to his word and take our own journey? Yeah, but God knows what's in each of our hearts. He knows when we're beginning to listen and strikes in our hearts that burning zeal, still allowing us to choose on our own and make a slow transformation. A step-by-step realization that one true and living God is standing right in front of us. And yes, that we must choose to climb our own sycamore tree. So, my dearest friends in Christ, you, the ones hearing this message, my brother and sister Zacchaeus, you may need to climb your own sycamore tree and reflect on your own. And realize that Jesus is telling you to come down quickly because he wants to stay at your house today. His love is the burning, that pulling, even that final push, getting you up that tree and then from the tree into his arms. To those of you willing to listen, truly listen, I say amen, so that, oh, you too may hear what dear Zacchaeus joyfully heard that day. Today, salvation has come to this house. Let us pray. God of all that is good, Heavenly Father, I beseech you, rain down your graces on all those hearing your word today, that they may truly listen and understand, that they may continue their journey to you and help be a shoulder for others' journey when asked. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Mm-hmm.